everyone. We're on the ferry to Vancouver Island
to meet up with Adrian O'Connor of Real Obsession Sport Fishing.
It's another Northwest Fishing Reports adventure, so
let's go fishing.
We have an adventure there, Aaron.
42 kilometers to go.
Heading out Esperanza Inlet here this morning. We got ourselves about a 30-minute ride out to the open water. We're going to start with some halibut fishing this morning. We kind of got the perfect tide for that. We got a low tide just after 8 o'clock this morning. So we're going to get out there about 8 miles offshore to one of our favorite little holes that we've been fishing for many years, and see what kind of damage we can do on some bottom fish. And it can be a great spot to fish salmon at times as well.
Adrian, you've got us fishing on a underwater hump. Tell us a little bit about what you're looking for when you're anchoring up for these halibut, what kind of structure and where the fish tend to lie.
Halibut can be in all kinds of different contour and structure areas. Typically more of a gradual hump or drop. Not a big steep pinnacle, but you will find them up on top of rock reefs and stuff like that. We'll find them in the gravel. We'll find them where the rock meets the sand. Where we're sitting today, it's just kind of a gradual hump, but it's just some boulder piles with some gravel mixed in. We're surrounded by sand, so it brings in the rockfish, the octopus, all the little stuff that these bigger halibut are going to be eating.
Did you want me to drop to the bottom? What was going on there, right? All the way to the bottom?
All the way, yeah. Basically, we want to be a foot or two up off the bottom. We do get the odd blue shark a little bit early in the season for them, right? And they'll pick the gear up sometimes when it's on its way down.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Mike, Adrian called that a dogfish. Are you fighting? Why are you fighting it like it's a tuna?
Hey. Tug is the drug. Cool.
Big dogfish? No, nope, just spit it out there. Bring it up, I'll have a look. That one's up in Acro line, it's pretty soft. So. There.
Hey, I got the first halibut of the day.
That one took our herring, so we got a few different offerings down there for him. We just lost one on the salmon there. Looks like they're not going to be too picky this morning for us.
Good.
So yeah, that's probably a perfect fish for our under possession limit. You know, that one's going to be right around that 81, 82 centimeter mark. So, good little eating fish,
and I'm eating them.
We're going to get that gear back. Get that gear back down and get a bigger one for us.
Yeah.
Right. Woo!
There he goes.
bite in 10 minutes now.
Let's see what we got here.
Let's have a look at that.
Oh, it's... Oh, I'm gonna eat him. I'm gonna eat him.
Oh, watch, he's not hooked that well. Maybe just get down to the water for a second Good. There.
Just a little more. Chicken, I think they call those chickens, huh?
Yeah, another little chicken. That one's, we'll take that one because that's probably another perfect 83 centimeter. And then the other two fish that we're allowed to take today, I think we're going to be a little bit more choosy with. Okay. Well, not bad. A couple fish in the boat in the first half hour. Get a little bit more choosy and try to get one of those
look at
big
that.
Ones
just
that
right
we,
there.
We know we're around. Yeah, he
just lightly hooked up, huh?
Yeah, look at that.
Just shows you how tough that skin is, though, that he was able to hold on the whole way coming up on that, right?
Right.
Yeah.
And that's the salmon belly.
Gotcha. Uh-huh. Yeah, fresh salmon belly, probably caught in the last few days here. I'm a big fan of fresh bait for these guys.
Sure.
You know, there's some guys that do like their stink baits, but I like my fresh bait for sure. That's what they're eating naturally, so.
It's working so far.
It is, isn't it? Yeah. Right on. Let's get this guy in the box.
Adrian, you got a nice office out here.
Not hard to take, eh? You know, no traffic in the morning besides those other four boats we were coming out with there. And yeah, look at the scenery, you know. One big picture window every day. I never take it for granted, that's for sure.
Strip them out and use them in your crab pots.
It's a little heavier than the dog.
Yeah,
it's
hotter.
Shaking much
in
the
mouth.
That one's got a little bit more weight to it. Nice. There we go. That's the one we're looking for, I think.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, dogfish on the deck. And Aaron's got an epic man versus fish saga being played out over here.
We'll keep that rod up there for a second till we get this other one in. Under the water. I don't want you to bring it above to the surface like you did with the little ones.
Okay.
See it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there's a nice fish. Nice one.
inclined up a little bit. Wow.
Cool. Welcome aboard.
Oh my goodness, look at that fish.
Okay. There's a beauty.
Can I get a woo?
Woo!
Yeah!
Not bad, third halibut and less than an hour of fishing, I'd say.
Yeah.
Come on. Little meat.
Fish.
Little meat in that one.
Uh-huh. Nice healthy fish, eh? Look at how bad it is. Beautiful spots on it. That one took the mackerel, so we've been getting them on everything. They're not being too picky this morning. We're giving them mackerel, herring, and salmon to choose from. I think we've had one on each one, eh, guys?
Yeah.
We missed a few bites as well. So.
This org, how does that feel?
Feels great. That is an amazing fish.
Yeah, that one's probably close to 60 pounds.
Take it. Home.
Hey, take it home in a box. Small vacuum pack.
There you go.
Oh, that's a fish.
Oh, man. That's a better fish.
Woo! Not that we've got a bad fish.
No, that's true.
You need help laying this knife?
Well, it's not going to be hoisted, if that's what you're asking.
Wow.
Fishing BC with Real Obsession. In halibut heaven.
Yeah, that one took a few minutes to decide if he was going to take it or not.
Yeah, and then he did that
suicide
bite. I think I'm ready to strip off my coat.
I'd say you got about 30, 40 feet to go from what I can see on the sounder there.
Nice. Oh, there he goes.
Just saw the light.
Yep.
Color.
I think he's a competitor for Aaron's fish, but
no, not.
What do you guys think? He's about 20 pounds. I think we'll let that one go this morning. We haven't been here long. We got lots of time to get some fish.
20 pounder, little guy, we're gonna let him go.
Nice and smooth, we'll say, yeah.
Now that's a big fish on the end of this line. Holy cow. Ugh, it's a beauty, I bet you it's a beauty fish. That's a beauty fish. Freaking monster. And it's a real temptation to just try to.
Yeah, that one didn't even really bite. It actually would just sucked the bait right in and was kind of holding right onto it. It almost looked like you were stuck on bottom there for a little bit, but it's moving with us now, so we know otherwise. We're gonna have to see. This fish could be a little bit over our size limit, but
before, right? Delta. We got a couple over 200.
The numbers of the fish that are around these days are really, really good, but we have noticed a decline in the number of big fish over the years. You know, with all the technology, the braided line, the GPS, you know, 15 years ago, you wouldn't see another boat out here anchored up for halibut. It would basically be me and there's a couple other guys, but it gets a little busier over the years and stuff like that. And like I said, with all that technology, it gives everybody a chance at getting some of this beautiful white meat.
We got it.
Okay, let's just keep that. Yeah, that's a beautiful fish.
Seems good.
Keep it under the water right now. Keep it down under the water, and then it doesn't feel the air surface. Come here, come on. I need her to turn a little bit.
All right.
Ready, guys? Coming on board. Welcome aboard.
Oh yeah! Whoa!
Sit here for a minute until she settles down.
Wow!
Watch that extra hook.
Healthy.
You know, well, there's a
that's why
twin
if
for
a
Aaron.
Small boat, you gotta be careful.
You gotta be careful. You know, we do harpoon them a lot of the time, but this one we brought in, no problem here. But
yeah.
You do have to be careful. You don't want to get that other hook swinging into your leg or get that fish knocking you overboard if you're fishing by yourself, right? That's the danger. So. That's a beauty, another beauty. Yeah. I think you and Aaron are gonna have to get down to half inches and pounds to see who's bigger on that one.
Neck.
Woo!
There you go.
Settle her down.
Man, it felt. It was fun. That was fun.
Bloody decks now.
Mm-hmm.
Right on, that's a beauty.
Be sure to watch part two of our Zeballos fishing adventures with Real Obsession Sport Fishing. Chinook salmon action, coming soon. Check out Real Obsession Sport Fishing on the web and on Facebook.
See, yeah, that fish is about one, probably about 120, 125, but I bet you it's, so that one's about 47, 48 inches. So the maximum size limit that we're allowed on halibut is 52 inches. That one comes in about 4 inches short, but it sure is fat. This fish is still gonna be close to 60 pounds, if not a little bit over, but I guess we'll find out at the end of the day at the dock when we're taking pictures, won't we?
Yeah.